wanted to provide a state of the district update and also a 2019 outlook. So I'm going to start right away with our vision and mission to make the best place to live, work, play, and raise a family, with a vision of happy kids engaged in healthy relationships on a path to gainful employment. And I think in order to achieve that, the first thing that we must achieve is comprehensive school and community safety. And so before the break, we convened with our middle school principals, our assistant principals, several district office staff, our coordinator of safety and security, Ryan Love, Captain Garmo from the San Diego Sheriffs, as well as Captain Rob Ransweiler from the Elko Police Department. Thank you for the five of you for being there present for that meeting. And from that, we scheduled six community town hall meetings. And so the schedule is now set. Beginning with February 7th, we'll be meeting at Hillsdale Middle School. The invitation will go out to the entire district in terms of all elementary site parents and students as well to attend either their feeder school or any of the other sites in terms of a safety conversation. A large portion of the presentation will be reporting from DMB and ACOM. In 2018, the governing board hired two security firms, one to look at our physical sites and the safety and security of us, the other one to look at behaviors, policies, procedures, and our knowledge of what to do in case of an emergency. And so we have those reports now. The next step will be to go out to the community to share our findings, to allow parents to give input, and to engage the entire community in conversation about safety. Because really, even though it is our responsibility, safety is everyone's responsibility. And according to law enforcement, the more we communicate with each other, the safer we can be. So each of you have a middle school in your trustee area, but please don't limit yourself to that school site in terms of participation. You're welcome to all of them to be both a governing board member, but an active participant as a community member as well. The other thing I'd like to share is our 2019-20 fiscal outlook. And the governor released a budget that was education friendly. And tomorrow, I think Joe and Scott and several of our team members will be attending the governor's budget workshop to hear more details on his plans. And we really won't know until the May revise and the June adoption in terms of what we actually have for the 19-20 budget. But I can speak to our own Cajon Valley budget. And thanks to Scott, our business services team, and our fiscal team here, happy to report that we are the only school district in San Diego County that for the last 6 years have had consecutive growth in terms of student enrollment. We have a healthy budget reserve. We have a 3-year budget projection in the black. I remember fondly the first year of my service as superintendent, we were deficit spending, and Justin Slagle slammed the dais and said, "We will not deficit spend anymore," and I wish he was here to hear, "We are not deficit spending anymore." And the last thing, we've spent money to make money, and I'll finish my report there. I'll just do some foreshadowing to share some of the things we've done creatively to make sure that when California's economic ebb and flow ebbs downward, that we are in a good position in terms of our fiscal stability. So a little bit about 2018. We started the year on Main Street, taking it over with El Cajon Police Department and Heart and Fire, and had a small party, and just going to show a clip. We could listen to the whole thing, but I think we'll spare our audience. But really, what I appreciate and what you don't see ahead of you is we have the Gallup Q12 questions right against the dais here. Show them in a minute. But the purpose of Creating a flash mob is not for a viral video, but for the process and the team building and the community that we build. I think if we want happy kids and healthy relationships on a path to gainful employment, we need to have happy employees engaged in healthy relationships, enjoying their gainful employment. And so the Gallup Q12 questions, which are right in front of us here on the screen, we appreciate your commitment to the health and well-being of not only the students, but our employees. We expressed that this morning in our management team meeting. I wish you could have heard some of the sentiments that our employees and the managers relayed in terms of creating place to work. And so just last month we had a small change, and before we acknowledge our new board president, Joe Alegria served 2 years as governing board president and did it extremely well. Let's please recognize our current board president. And so we had an election. We had Joe Alegria and Tamara and Joe Bardo reelected. So we had no change on our governing board, which we want to applaud also. But we do welcome a new president, Tamara Otero, returning to the president role. And also exciting announcements from CSBA.
Yesterday, CSBA's Delegate Assembly elected Tamara Otero from the Cajon Valley Union School District as CSBA's 2019 Vice President.
And shortly after, she was mobbed by the San Diego School Board delegates. These are our San Diego reps that were part of the voting committee. And so Tamara will be president-elect next year, and then will be CSBA president the following year. And right now, having Turner from La Mesa Spring Valley is president, and Tam is vice president. All the power in California is in the East County. So last year at this time, we talked about some of our big whys were, and we looked at the 43,000 young people in San Diego that are not at work and not going to school. They're called San Diego's opportunity youth, roughly 1 in 10 students. One of the things that are significant to us is a large percentage of those students in San Diego reside right here in the East County. And so we asked the question, how do we bridge the gap between education and the world of work? Based on a settlement that Cajon Valley was able to wield from the San Diego County Office of Education towards the tune of about $3 million, we used a portion of our settlement money to take the governing board on an edutour. And we took our governing board, several staff, several principals across the country to look at how can we utilize some of our assets in terms of physical property, and what are some of the most innovative things happening in the country in terms of creating a modern workforce. So we visited WeWork, we visited Upwork, we visited the Foundry and Fraser Public Schools in Michigan, and here's a short clip of our tour.
We're all about in the middle of our trip right now. It's been a whirlwind time. We're busy, we're focused, we're inspired, we're tired. But I think right now we're in a place where our inspiration is starting to form, and we're excited to come home and see what we can do.
Without ever being here, we never could have got the full picture of what this is about. So to see it, to smell it, to touch all that we're experiencing here, it's a really powerful experience. Definitely well worth coming out here.
This trip, it hasn't been easy, but our kids are worth it.
And I think it's really an innovative approach to learning that they're taking, and seeing a school district that's willing to take the time to travel the country and learn from businesses and other spaces that are doing innovative things around maker education shows me that there is going to be an incredible change in education in this country, and the people from Cajon Valley are going to lead the way.
And then following our trip, we came home and we took our ideas from the National Council on Digital Convergence, Some of the language we've been working with our community, our city council, and community leaders in terms of making El Cajon the best place to live, work, play, and raise a family. The concepts of happy kids and healthy relationships on a path to gainful employment, and we formalized our district mission and vision together early in spring, which meant that we had a commitment to our students to fulfill that promise in the world and modern curriculum. And so in computer science and presentation literacy and social emotional learning in the world of work, we began the school year with a brand new adoption in language arts, with some new curriculum and a newly designed social emotional learning curriculum for our middle schools.
CV Conference is multiple days of professional learning for classified and certificated staff in Cajon Valley. We like to end our conference with something fun and light and motivating to kick off the new year. This year, our theme is the 80s.
It's just a great time to build those relationships with your staff, with your coworkers, before the year starts.
We're more than a number here. We're actually a family, and I feel we have the opportunity to have so much input in moving forward in everything this district is doing to meet the needs of all of our students.
CV Conference is great because you get a chance to learn new things and connect with people and have a positive start to the school year. There's a lot of things I've done in my 31 years that I think can help, but then there's teachers that have been here 1 year and can teach me new things.
This was a great opportunity for me to see what is going on in the schools, the impact, the programs that we implemented have on these students.
What's nice about this experience is it's not just a bunch of people shuffling from class to class. There's a theme, you know, you get a chance to show your creativity. It makes it more fun, it makes it more lively, it's entertaining. It's not just this thing that you have to do, but it's the thing that you want to go to.
We have over 100 sessions being offered. We have sessions for everybody. We want to make sure everyone felt included and have a place where they can go learn specifically for their content.
Those conferences did help me a lot doing my job in a more professional way. Being part of Cajon Valley community, it was really a good experience.
When you're part of the Cajon Valley team, you are part of something bigger that no one else is doing. And I think the big picture is hearing the message, what are we all trying to achieve? And it is the vision, it is our mission. It is about happy kids and healthy relationships on a path to gainful employment.
So there's a lot of talk about personalized learning, and the way that we frame it is really about the student. And at the center of the core process is the mission of ME, which is the mission of every child in our district, their academic journey, their interests and values, and help craft their story in terms of path to gainful employment. This has garnered lots of attention. Shortly thereafter, we were invited in April to speak and present at ASU-GSV, which is the largest global conference in terms of future of work and education meeting each other. Some of the keynote speakers, just our caliber. And then several school leaders from across the country came through our school to see this work in action.
We are so excited to be here at Cajon Valley Union School District. It's part of ASU-GSV, and we're hosting teachers, principals, superintendents, technology officers from all around the United States.
World of Work is an opportunity for kids to really explore interests.
I just had a tour from a kindergarten student who was able to not only identify his work, but also identify the career that he wants to pursue, and that is huge for our kids.
And today we specifically brought them by to see what does the world of work look like authentically integrated into everyday curriculum so that students have the opportunity to think about their strengths, interests, and values and what careers they might have and what that might look like in the classroom.
I am so in awe, so amazed. This was a phenomenal opportunity. I will absolutely be back.
I'm so proud to share these resources with people from ASU-GSV, from all over the country. Everyone's chasing the American dream, and to make these resources available from the world of work to everyone will allow everyone to achieve that.
We've been invited back this year to ASU-GSV and will also host site visits again. So please mark your calendars April 8th and 10th, 8th through 10th. Registration is open now. We do anticipate being comped for the conference again since we are opening our schools, and we also have been given spots to speak and present on their stage. Coming up a little bit faster than that in just a few weeks is the National Council on Digital Convergence. So we were there as participants last year. This year we are co-host. And day one will be a pre-conference right here in our district. February 4th, we'll have about 200 school leaders from across the country and influencers in the political realm coming through our schools. We have our Ed Services team and facilitators prepping and getting ready to be our leaders on our tours. And here's what they're coming to see: happy kids and healthy relationships on a path to gainful employment, the world of work. And they're really intrigued by TEDx Kids at El Cajon and presentation literacy and the idea that students as early as kindergarten can give a TED Talk on stage. Following that, we'll be in day two of the conference, and we'll have sessions on social-emotional learning, as well as the world of work, and a convening of educational leaders around the conversation on how do we scale this work nationwide. One of the biggest visits we had this year was Tom Vander Ark, former chairman of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and a leader in the education space, trying to help us share this work so that more kids can benefit.
The challenge in education today is preparing students for a very different future, one where every job is going to be augmented by new forms of technology. So we think that means not only strong basic skills, but a whole new set of skills, the kind of skills that students are learning in Cajon Valley, the ability to design, to step into complex situations that they've never seen before, the ability to interact with diverse groups of people to solve problems, the ability to be an entrepreneur, to take responsibility for their own learning and identify initiative wherever it is and deliver value. And it's so exciting to see elementary age students learning those skills in Cajon Valley.
One of the reasons we're so invested in this work is that we see our school systems are built on archaic designs that really don't meet the needs of students and families today. And it's not that it's broken, it's that the system is actually operating exactly as it was designed, but that's not reflective of what we need today. So one of the things that we're really vested in is finding ecosystems like we found right here that are really dismantling that system and saying we need something different and we need to put the pieces back together, thinking about the humans that we're serving first.
So Cajon Valley is the best example that we've seen of career education in elementary and middle school. But more important than that, students here are really learning to take responsibility for their own learning. They're coming to understand their strengths and their interests and their values, and that's exciting to see. As communities, we can support that by opening up our businesses and our organizations to young people, inviting schools to become partners, allowing our coworkers to visit classrooms, and making those strong school-to-work connections.
And next week we have a call with Gallup to look at our student engagement results. And the Gallup student poll measures engagement, hope, career financial literacy, and entrepreneurial aspiration. And national trends show that kids in fifth grade are about 74% engaged, and by high school, 2 out of 3 have checked out. And last year, our student engagement scores were far above the national average. This year, I understand we're about the same, but we have data to look at for engagement, hope, and entrepreneurialism. And what I want to talk about here is the California dashboard. So last month, we got our report card from the state of California on Common Core reading and Common Core math assessments. Our board has talked about the idea of common sense versus Common Core. So according to our board, we're doing okay. But what I want to really emphasize here is that some of the assessments that we're measuring are the same assessments that we've been using for 100 years. And the reason that so many people are coming to see our schools and our district is because we're looking at metrics that matter in terms of health, well-being, and gainful employment. And so looking at the World Economic Forum and educational skills, education innovation, 21st century curriculum, digital fluency, lifelong learning pathways, and relevant specialized education is what happens here. Their last rung is quality basic education, which is a piece, and literacy and numeracy are absolutely one of our foundations. Their skills outlook for 2022, it shows in the decline area, reading, writing, math, and active listening. That doesn't mean that those things aren't important, but what the World Economic Forum is saying is that school districts globally have to look at other priorities as a balance to make sure that kids are actively pursuing an actual path to gainful employment. And back to our last piece is spend money to make money. So we've done very well over time with fiscal management. We have a strong budget, but California's enjoyed several years of strong economy, and that's not going to last forever. What this board has done is, as we've created the world of work for our own kids, we found that this work was in demand at other places. And so we were able to license a trademark, get a copyright, and most recently share our work with other school districts. This is from the California School Boards Association. And this morning, Scott, our attorney Joey from BBK, Sharon Clay, and Ed and I had a conversation about the process turning this resource World of Work from a resource from our students into a revenue-generating opportunity for our district over time. And here's that conversation. It's amazing to think a year ago where we were just getting started, and then here we are now with version 2.0 of our product and $100,000 in revenue, and our kids are clearly articulating their strengths, interests, and values. So 2018 was a great year. 2019, the future has no ceiling, and it gets started right away with Learn It, going to NCDC and ASU-GSV, and I know that each of you will be right there alongside for this crazy ride we're on. Thank you very much.